Hello learners, I am Dr. Preeti Dharmik, Assistant Professor in UGC Human Resource Development Center, Rashtrasant Tukdoji Maharaj, Nagpur University, Nagpur. In this module, we will discuss health effects of probiotics and their mechanism of action. Here we will focus on several important mechanisms underlying the antagonistic effect of probiotics on various microorganisms. The mechanisms of probiotic function includes enhancement of epithelial barrier, increased adhesion to intestinal mucosa, inhibition of pathogen adhesion, competitive exclusion of pathogenic microorganisms, production of antimicrobial substances, and the last one is modulation of immune system. Later we will discuss these mechanisms in detail with respect to following activities such as antipathogenic, urinogenital health care, anti-diabetic, anti-inflammatory, anti-cancer activity, anti-allergic activity, angiogenic activity, and the effect of probiotics on brain and central nervous system. As we all know, probiotics possess important functional attributes that could fulfill most of our basic nutritional and clinical supplementation requirements. These microbes have shown positive responses to clinical treatment against several diseases and disorders. Moreover, the contribution of probiotics in preventing and treatment of diabetes, obesity, cancer, and diseases related to pathogenic microbes is an exciting and rapidly advancing research arena. Probiotics have demonstrated significant potential as therapeutic options for a variety of diseases, but the mechanisms responsible for these effects have not been fully elucidated yet. Hence, this module we will focus on several important mechanisms underlying the antagonistic effects of probiotics on various microorganisms. Now let's have a look on mechanisms of probiotic functions. The mechanisms of probiotic function includes enhancement of epithelial barrier, increased adhesion to intestinal mucosa, inhibition of pathogen adhesion, competitive exclusion of pathogenic microorganisms, production of antimicrobial substances, and last one is modulation of immune system. All the above mechanisms are depicted in following figure as well as table. Let's have a look on first mechanism of action, that is nothing but barrier function. As we all know, the intestinal tract is a diverse microenvironment where more than 500 species of bacteria thrive. A single layer of epithelium is all that separates these commensal microorganisms and pathogens from the underlying immune cell and thus epithelial barrier function as a key component. The epithelial barrier consists of a dense mucus layer containing secretory IgA, that is antibody A, and antimicrobial peptides, as well as dynamic junctional complexes that regulate permeability between cells. Probiotics are live microorganisms that confer benefits to the host and that have been suggested to prevent diseases including antibiotic-associated diarrhea, irritable bowel syndrome, and inflammatory bowel disease. Probiotics are capable of influencing many of the components of epithelial barrier function, either by decreasing apoptosis of intestinal cell or increased mucin production. Lactobacillus species have been shown to increase mucin expression in vitro in human intestinal epithelial cells, thus blocking pathogenic E. coli invasion as well as adhesion. The second mechanism of action is production of antimicrobial substances. Probiotics, either by inducing host cell to produce peptides or by directly releasing peptides, interfere with pathogens and prevent epithelial invasion. Antimicrobial substances like defensins are the antimicrobial peptides expressed constitutively by intestinal epithelial cells and display antimicrobial activity against variety of bacteria, fungi and some of the viruses. Probiotics have been shown to suppress pathogen growth through the release of variety of antimicrobial factors like defensins, bacteriocins, hydrogen peroxide, nitric oxide, as well as short chain fatty acids such as lactic acid and acetic acids. Microcins, on the other hand, can target inner membrane as well as enzymes that are involved in DNA or RNA structure synthesis as well as protein synthesis. Similarly, the production of hydrogen peroxide by these bacterial groups causes the oxidation of sulfhydryl groups, resulting in denaturation of several enzymes, results in peroxidation of membrane lipids, thus increasing membrane permeability of pathogenic microorganisms, consequently cell death. Some of these compounds may act by lowering the pH by organic acids like lactic as well as acetic acid. The third mechanism of action is competition for adherence. Competition of commensals and probiotic bacteria with the pathogens for adhesion and colonization is one of the important protective mechanisms of gastrointestinal tract. The epithelial cells of gastrointestinal tract are protected from pathogenic bacteria by number of mechanisms. One of them is reduction in pathogenic infection through competition of microbiota for adhesion sites with microbial pathogens and production of components with antimicrobial activity. To cause infection, pathogenic bacteria, after penetrating the intestinal mucus, must adhere to the enterocytes. The initial step of adhesion in case of Salmonella species is mediated by bacterial fimbri, which recognize certain receptors on the eukaryotic cells. Several studies indicated that lactic acid bacteria could prevent the attachment of pathogens, in this way reducing colonization and prevent infection. Similarly, S. boulardii secretes heat labile factor, which has shown to be responsible for decreased bacterial adherence. Another mechanism by which probiotic exerts antipathogenic activity is by competing for available nutrients and growth. So friends, till now in this module, we have seen three mechanisms of probiotic action. Those are enhancement of barrier function, production of antimicrobial peptides or substances, and competition for adherence.